We have a very challenging problem with stereotyping around technology. When you get to school, we somehow have this idea that math and science people are smarter. The reason why I bring up this society challenge is because if you start mentioning AI and tech, people feel nervous. Just add someone in your team who speaks these languages and use your values and insights together with their values to evolve these technologies to be better.
What are the areas where you think that the application of technology can be most fruitful in helping us fight climate change, given that this is a race against time?
The good news is there's an awful lot of solutions already out there. When I was a student, we raced across Australia in a solar-powered car. And I always wondered, like, why can't we get moving? And we can't get moving because we don't know we could get moving. Instead of only scouting in, say, Silicon Valley or London, go look everywhere and support them the way that we support my colleagues Jeff Bezos or Elon Musk. There's someone on this planet who's figured out something genius. If we help them, we can have that.
You're telling bankers in the room to go find the people who are innovators and bank them. You're in a room with people who will look at the hard facts of the bottom line.
Right.
Are you talking of corporate social responsibility?
You will enjoy the economics of owning pieces of those businesses. And it's really doable, and it's our choice. If we don't do it, we will have a really messed up society. If we do it, we have opportunity.
And if we bankers do not quickly recognize that our business model is becoming obsolete and we don't do few of the things that you're talking about here, our bottom line will disappear.
I think that what I take from this is that when you combine technology with talent and passion, mm-hmm. and you have shown a lot of passion, great things can emerge.